this is you running through a freeway in South Africa selling energy drinks. Now, this is surrounded by minibus taxis, hijackers, just people who drive in Joburg. Absolutely fearless. And this is you yet again being an entrepreneur. You're trying to flog energy drinks in rush hour traffic.
Yeah. It's entrepreneurship, I think, you know, he can attest to it. Obviously, he's done it under a different climate in the US, right? Yeah, where you started your tech companies. It's a different ball game here in South Africa, especially if you're trying to get into a space where there are no black people. So what I'm doing is groundbreaking because I'm the first black man in the world to create an energy drink back in 2011. And for me to get it into the market, it's not easy because, you know, you don't have the government institutions backing you, you don't have capital, you do not have any investments. And, you know, I did very well from when I was 21 years old up until 31, 32. You know, I had to downgrade and get rid of the sports cars and get rid of one or two of my properties so we can invest in this vision and this dream of building our own African Coca-Cola. So for me, it's always, I'm gonna do whatever it takes to make it succeed. It's not easy, it's a lot of work. I'm not even looking at the high score, I'm not even thinking about success, I'm just enjoying the journey. It's been 4 years right now. It's been a great journey. 2 years of research and development when we started, being in the market for 3 years, barriers to entry in the retail space, and I come up with a beautiful model where I empower unemployed young people in the townships, unemployed graduates, and students that want to make a bit of extra cash. I supply the wholesalers nationwide, and I use you know, over 2 million of my followers on across all my social media platforms. I communicate to them to go buy the drinks at an affordable rate at the wholesalers, and go out there in the street and sell it anyway, whether it's at a varsity, whether it's at a church, whether it's street corners.
Let me say something, that when I first saw that video, I thought that was awesome, because so many entrepreneurs and so many CEOs would be afraid to do that, not for the reasons that you said, but because they want this image. And I thought of someone. As soon as I saw that, I thought of an entrepreneur. And we only make decisions on two fronts. We either make decisions based on fear or based on opportunity. Every decision in your life, you can look at it. And I won't ask your wife the question whether it was fear or opportunity. But what I will say, the entrepreneur I thought when he was doing that was Richard Branson. This is the South African Richard Branson right here.